Hey guys, thanks for checking out the podcast. Before we get started, I want to remind you about the very cool bucket list trip I am doing in 2026, the Smitty Learns Irish podcast, where I'm going to do my bucket list, hike Ireland for a year, learn about Irish history, town by town, through the mouths of the pub owners and regulars. Because what's a better way to learn about something you love than to experience it yourself? Patreon.com/we3smiths, only $3 a month, and thanks for checking it out. And welcome to the Rock Radar. My name is Smitty from the What the Hell Everything podcast. Another stoner reaction, my first ever listen and reaction to Lorna Shore. Before I get to the reaction, shout out to my sponsor, M22 in Sutton's Bay in northern Michigan, right just north of Traverse City. If you know of the area, you know how gorgeous it is. You know how much awesome shit there is to do. And you do visit, you need a quaint, comfortable, affordable little inn. There you go, M22 right on West Grand Traverse Bay. Click the link in the description if you so choose. Now, Lorna Shore is a band I've looked at doing before. The whole idea behind the Rock Radar is for me to find my next favorite rock and metal bands. It could be an old band, one that I've never heard of, new to me, or a brand new band, essentially. And I've seen this band's name kicked around a bunch, and I've seen them getting kicked around a bunch by people that don't like them, even though I know there's a lot of people that do like them. Now, first off, when I see deathcore, I'm immediately turned off. It's just I've had a large sampling size of heavy, heavy deathcore stuff, and historically it doesn't sit well with me. But the whole idea behind the Rock Radar, again, is to open my rock and roll mind, okay? So gonna give it a listen. Now, I don't believe that this song, I looked it up a little bit. I did do some research on this. Lorna Shore, the song that we're doing is Into the Hellfire, or To the Hellfire, excuse me. And it doesn't look like it's, it just looks like it's just a single release. It's not on the 2020 album or the 2022 album from Lorna Shore. So I'm assuming it was just a one-off single, but it's their biggest hit, the one we're going to listen to. So, no better time than the present, Smitty. I like that. Yeah, this is definitely not my cup of tea. To me, so much, you know, and if you followed my journey along these reaction videos, sort of my bridges, things I've come to love about, like, some vocalists, like Devin Townsend and things, you know, I can find some bridges into that hardcore death metal kind of shit, you know. Some of it still just doesn't sit very well with me. And one of my... maybe I'm just getting old, but I felt like this for a lot of years. There's just something about it. It loses like discernible riffs and layers, and they're doing some cool shit in here. 100%. They're doing some cool shit. Maybe my brain can't go that fast and keep up with the very fucking technical metal that I know that they're pulling off. You know what I mean? I can tell they're doing their shit at a high level, and I... even though those vocals do not appeal to me what so fucking ever, I recognize the talent. You know what I mean? I recognize the talent. I just now realized that this is a 6-minute song, and I'm like, oh boy. And I'm hoping, that something turns around and they do a little switcheroo or something. Who knows? There's already people that love this band that fucking just like, fuck you, and they just fucking downvoted it and fucking all that shit. And they already left. That sounds fucking pretty cool. This section right here. Let me get back to it a little bit. Let me rewind it a little bit. For whatever reason, that grabbed me a little more. I could totally appreciate a lot of what they're doing musically. There's some of it that really grabs me. Again, the thing that I have against like super fast fucking metal all the time. I want a lot of nuance in my music when I listen to it, you know? And again, discernible riffs. But I can appreciate and am hit by certain parts of the song because they're doing some really cool, nice layering. I don't know if those are keys going in or what, but some really cool layers happening. All right, so I do want to acknowledge that. Fun. mean, first and foremost, these guys fucking slam. You know what I mean? They really do hit, and you can tell that the production's on. You can tell the band is fucking tight as hell. It didn't really work for me going back into that acoustic section before this ripping ass solo. I was like, oh, what are they gonna do? And then into the solo, it just didn't work for me. But again, you can just tell these guys are at a high fucking level, man. Actually, I like that little section right there. It sounded like a fucking haunted house, and shit was going ape shit like in Insidious or Conjuring or something. You know what I mean? That's what it sounds like. It sounds like a haunted house. Fucking demons are coming out. Which hence to the Hellfire, right? I actually really like this fucking section. Man, I actually really like that last 30, 40 seconds. Whatever that fucking section was, whatever they were doing. Sometimes sounding demonic as fuck is enough. Overall, I gotta say, I was fairly impressed with the song. The vocals, for the most part, though. I'm just like, ow, my Bell's palsy ear that still hurts. Hey, you like my thoughts on this? Maybe you want to hear my thoughts on other things. Got the What the Hell Everything podcast live streams on Patreon. And then I go down rabbit holes from bands I fall in love with on the Rock Radar on Patreon as well, with live stuff and B-sides and fucking album reviews and all that stuff. So thank you. I appreciate you. And till next time. What the hell, everything?